how are some different ways we can bring our kids from Sioux Falls together or East River together with our athletes from the reservations in South Dakota? And one of the easiest ways to do it is through high school basketball. So what we really started to hope for was maybe a 4 or 5 game opening classic turned into a 9 game, 18 team high school classic where every game is set up so a school from the reservation or in the likes of one of our games, a bordering school, a school that borders a major reservation, is playing a school from an urban area that's got distance between a reservation or areas where Native American athletes would come together. In the hopes that not only would we start to be able to build some relationships on the court, but also be able to use that time to maybe teach a little bit about the culture and start to gain a better understanding when it comes to where our kids are coming from the reservations and some of the things that they feel are very important to them that maybe other people don't understand. When you think of South Dakota high school basketball and some of the really awesome places to be able to play, the Corn Palace is so nostalgic. And so we reached out to Mitchell right away when we first thought about this and said, hey, do you have any open dates? And so the two biggest questions we always get asked is, why are you doing it January 4th and why are you doing Mitchell? Well, to be honest with you, January 4th was the only day the Corn Palace had available. It was the only Saturday, so that's why it's on the 4th. But we wanted to be able to provide an experience for the kids. And for a lot of our kids, especially our Native American athletes, this is gonna be the first time they've ever been in the Corn Palace, let alone play a basketball game. And even for some of our East River kids, they don't get the opportunity a lot of times.
We don't have the Native American culture in our area. And we don't play against it very often. Last year was one time when we went to Redfield, we played Flander Indian up there for the last 2 years practice. Other than that, we haven't played a Native American school, but we have all of them in our class. I mean, Red Cloud and Pine Ridge, Cheyenne Eagle Butte, you know, they're all Class A schools, and we could very well go out to Cheyenne Eagle Butte and play in March. You know, they're kids, they're great. I was talking with Charles in the hallway after I came out of the locker room, he was right there with me, and I'm joking with him, I go, Charles, man, you guys just, why, don't shoot so dang well next time. And, you know, he's laughing, we're having fun, and I mean, that's what it is about. That's why this is a great event for that, and, you know, they're all kids, and they're all out here to compete and have fun and play the game of basketball.
The whole capture of it, I've been talking to Alan, you know, I coach with Sacred Hoops, so I knew this was coming in the summertime. But to bring the Native Americans, you know, the natives from the west part of the state to collaborate with these teams, you know, is really good. I got to meet the new coaches, you know, the other team we played, every single one of them are respectful. And if everybody in the state can do what we're doing today, I think South Dakota would be just fine.